Well, hello everyone, it's John, and this is the first series of an indefinite number of series. I don't know how many videos it's going to take, but this series is going to be showing you how I construct a steam engine from castings in a home machine shop. The engine that I've chosen is an engine that I have built before. It's also a very popular engine with home machinists, and it's also very popular with people that have the small mini lathes, such as the Harbor Freight lathe, the Grizzly 7x10, 7x12, 7x14 type lathes. And this engine that I've chosen here, it can easily be built on those lathes. This engine I have actually built before, so it's not an unfamiliar engine with me. So it fits the category of being relatively inexpensive. The castings shipped are close to, I think, about $65, $70 shipped to your door. The shipping is very quick. PM Research is a very good company to do business with. Like I say, I have built, I think this is probably my fifth engine from them. And I've been very satisfied. The shipping's real good. The customer service, if you have any questions or goof up a part, you can buy the individual parts if that were necessary to do that. The goal here is to show you not necessarily a blow by blow, but more of the process that one goes through. I'll try to put as many setups in the video series as I can do. I'll show you how I do the machining on the lathe of the different parts. So hopefully over the course of the next 2 or 3 months, you'll see the engine evolve in a series of short videos. I'll try to keep the videos around 5 minutes for several reasons. One is mostly just the uploading time that it takes to upload a video. So that's about it. I will show you the box and what comes in it, and we'll do a brief unboxing and then we'll wrap this video up. This is the box that the little steam engine castings come in, and it's packed very well. They really do a really good job of that. These are the blueprints, and I'll talk more about those blueprints, and I'll show you what to do with those in just a few minutes. Lay that aside. And in the box are the castings themselves. And what we mean by castings are, this is the way that they come out of the foundry. For example, there's no holes here for the crankshaft. The base is only got a foundry finish on it. Nothing is machined flat. Even though these are excellent castings, these are some of the best castings that that you will normally find from a foundry. They do a really good job of that. This is the cylinder, and of course it's got a core in it, but it has not been bored out. There's nothing in here for the valving or anything. We'll have to machine all of that out. It's got a flywheel that will need to be finished on it. Over here are some more aluminum castings. These are the cylinder heads, the crosshead guides, and some other little gadgets that are in there. These are stainless steel screws, and of course everything has to be threaded and drilled out for the screws. And then there's just some miscellaneous brass pieces here. Some of these brass pieces will become the piston. Other brass pieces, at this time, it's been a while since I built the engine. I can't recall what all the brass pieces are, but all of those will be used for different things. Next, I'll show you the blueprints and what they look like. This is one page of the prints that are with it, and this is an exploded drawing of the engine. Along the top here are some notes, and along the side over in here are the different descriptions of what all's in the kit. It looks like there's about 32 items within this kit, and this exploded drawing shows how everything is put together. By the way, there are a lot of engines out through there that you don't get this exploded drawing with, so this is also very helpful. This kit is not something that I would say you buy your lathe one day and start machining this kit the next day. However, there have been people who have done that, and they've done it very successfully, I might say. But normally this would be one where you learn to do your basic turning and finishing. But this will be a good kit to start on after you have learned the basic operations of a lathe. Here is the blueprints. Well, what you see there are these are the blueprints or the drawings of the engine, and they're on probably a 24 by, I'd say, 36 inch sheet of paper. I'll come in a little closer so that you can see the dimension drawings of something. For example, right here is a drawing of the crank casting. So you can see here where you have a hole that's drilled through the middle of it. Looks like a 9/64 drill through, four holes equally spaced and so forth. Three-quarter diameter bolt circle. You've got a valve that's at the bottom of it that's 31 across and looks like 498 in diameter and so forth. I'm reading this through the little screen and not the actual blueprint itself. Now, I won't be using this in this form. I'll show you what I do with the blueprints in the next video, but this gives you an overview of the kit itself and some of the things that I'll be doing as we construct this little PM Research Model 3 steam engine. I'll see you on the next video.